The desktop RTX 3060, which was announced quite a while ago, is now finally coming to market, and we are going to be talking about it in today's video, as well as AMD's competitor to DLSS and how mining is causing some real issues in Iran. So we are going to be talking about really shortly, but I would like to give a massive shout out to all of you guys who have watched the video I've done together with Bob, Steven, Jared, and Brandon. And if you don't know these people, then definitely check out the links in the video description, because you might see some familiar faces right there. So let's start with the RTX 3060, and this one is going to be really weird if I do say so myself, because this time around we are not going to be getting a Founders Edition, and I think I made that pretty clear in the other videos where I have been talking about this card. Now, Nvidia has been pretty weird with all of the releases, and we've seen that on the desktop, on the mobile side of things as well, but with the 3060 we are now finally going to see the GA106 chip, and it's not that we haven't seen it, because, well, it is in on the RTX 3060 mobile as well, but there are still some differences between them, and we are going to be talking about it. But just so you know, you can't really compare them, you know, apples to apples. So what I would like to do right now is go through the specs which we have seen from video cards, which are saying that we are going to see a base clock frequency of 1.32 gigahertz and a boost of 1.77 gigahertz for this card, with 3584 CUDA cores, 28 ray tracing cores, and 112 Tensor cores. And next to that, we're getting 12 gigabytes of VRAM across a 192-bit bus and a TGP of around 170 watts, and that obviously depends on the model which you are going to be getting, because if you are going to go with a card from EVGA, which is going to be their top of the line, let's say, or from ASUS, you might see that it might take some extra juice, so I don't know, 180 190, depending on the case. Now, you might have noticed that I said that we have gotten the GA106 chip for the RTX 3060 mobile, but you might have also noticed, if you have done any kind of research, that these cards are, well, these GPUs, and now I'm talking about the dies, they're not really the same. Now, on the mobile side of things, we are going to be getting 6 gigabytes of VRAM, and on the desktop card, we're finally seeing that we are going to be getting 12 gigabytes. Now, obviously, this kind of also makes me think that we might be seeing a 3066 gig variant at some point, because we have seen this with the GTX 1060, that one had 3 and 6 gigabytes. So maybe Nvidia is also planning to release something after the RTX 3060. Now, I would also like to point out that I have no clue in terms of how this card is going to perform. Technically, if we are to go after what we have seen with the RTX 3070 and 3060 Ti, you might see that this card theoretically, so really get your salt shakers out, theoretically it could be similar to the 2070 Super or the 2080 from last generation, and that's of course going off of what we've seen with the 3060 Ti and the RTX 3070. Now, you probably might be thinking to yourself, why are we getting 12 gigabytes of VRAM on this GPU, and why the faster memory speeds? Well, I guess Nvidia had to choose between 6 or 12 for this GPU, and knowing that AMD is going to be releasing their RX 6700 and 6700 XT GPUs with 12 gigs, I guess they kind of wanted to go head to head against them so they could get even more market share. Now, with regards to that price of $329 or 329 euros if you are from Europe, I wouldn't be that sure that this is exactly the price which we are going to be seeing for any cards. So there might be some cards or one particular GPU from maybe PNY which is going to sell for $329 or euros, but I really think that is still really far-fetched at the moment, because if you don't know, we're going through the human malware, we still have the new tariffs which are really changing the prices right now, we're still dealing with bots, scalpers, and cryptocurrency miners, which are of course influencing the prices. So I don't really think that this card is going to be selling for anywhere near $329 or euros. And speaking of that, there have already been some prices released for the RTX 3060 in some countries, and believe it or not, like we have seen with the 3060 Ti and 3070 before, some people have managed to get their hands early on these cards, and we have also seen that the performance for this card, and I know I talked about the gaming, the possible gaming performance, but the mining performance has leaked, I guess, and the person who was able to test it said that he got about 50 mega hashes per second, and I don't really know if that's a lot or if that's bad. I have no clue. Hopefully it's not going to be all that great, but by looking at it, I really think that this card is going to be really favored, or you know, the chosen one for cryptocurrency miners. But of course, let's now talk about AMD and what they are going to be doing. And I'm not going to be talking about the 6700 or the 6700 XT because I have other videos talking about it, and there haven't really been much more developments about that. But there have been some developments with regards to their DLSS competitor, which is pretty much FidelityFX Super Resolution, or FFSR, as I would like to call it. And I guess that didn't work out as I expected, but nevertheless, this is not going to be this is not going to work like DLSS does, which is, you know, through machine learning and AI, and I really know those are buzzwords, but you also have to think that NVIDIA really focuses on AI quite a lot, and their second version of DLSS has brought quite a few nice improvements, and AMD is going to be finally, allegedly, be bringing their FFSR alternative sometime in March, if the new rumors are to be believed, and this might actually come part of their bigger driver update, because you might also know that AMD really likes to update their drivers, and in the, you know, in the meantime, really screw up some things, just to put it mildly. But the problem that I have with FFSR is that it's A, not working through machine learning, but much rather what it does is going to change different resolutions during the fast-paced gameplay scenes, so it might not always be perfect and you might very well see different results. So if your playstyle is something like 360 MLG no scope, then it might be very different from someone who plays games in a really chill way like you would have in some RPGs. So I'm not a particularly big fan of that whenever I'm reading those things, but maybe they are going to make it work with their first edition, and we are not going to get like a sour taste first, and then we're gonna have to wait for a second better iteration, just like we have seen with NVIDIA's DLSS. Maybe AMD can finally prove us wrong with those things, because to be frank, we need this. A, and B, we have seen them doing some excellent job with FreeSync, and I know these things don't really have a lot to do, but I really like what they have done with FreeSync and, you know, all of the advantages which we're now starting to see on newer monitors. And of course, if we are going to want to play games on our 30 and 6000 series GPUs, and I'm talking about NVIDIA and AMD, not the older NVIDIA 6000 series, of course, we might actually be able to benefit from those things, especially if other companies are going to join in on the whole process and make it open source, essentially. But we're going to see about that, and we're also most probably going to see how the whole situation with the whole mining craze is going to evolve or devolve, I guess. I don't really know how this is going to pan out for all of us, but what I want to tell you is that in Iran we have already started seeing some power outages. Now, of course, we're not talking about any power outages happening, I guess, in pretty much all over the world, because those still happen from time to time. No, my friends, these have been caused primarily by whole new Chinese companies which are bringing their mining rigs to Iran, because electricity is apparently so much cheaper right there compared to China, and I guess by extension compared to Germany, where we have the most expensive electricity. And I know I probably have said this in 10 or so videos wherever I touched on this, but I digress. I would like to point out that This has been leading to a lot of issues, and by that I mean those 14 large mining farms are now consuming about 300 megawatts of power. And according to video cards, they have started receiving a lot more of those pictures to their publication on a daily basis. And I would also recommend that you guys read the article from France 24 on which the video cards article is based on, because they have a lot more information and it's really interesting. I might even want to see someone do a deeper dive on what's going on at the moment, so maybe one of you is going to do that. Otherwise, I guess I'm gonna have to find some other sources for it. And in Georgia, and I'm talking about the country, not the state, there seem to be some very similar problems going on at the moment. So I can't really say that I'm the biggest fan of cryptocurrency mining at the moment, just because I'm kind of thinking about how much damage this actually does to the environment compared to the financial system and all of that. But obviously I'm not going to make a video talking about it. I'm just here to tell you what's going on, and then you could probably let me know what you think about what's happening in the comments down below. And I would lastly like to talk about Tesla, because our meme overlord Elon Musk has finally decided to invest himself in Bitcoin. And I'm not only he probably bought Bitcoin before, you know, but this time around Tesla is going to be acquired $1.5 billion worth of Bitcoin, which obviously made the price skyrocket. So if you have invested in Bitcoin and Dogecoin, then you probably should check to see how much more money you have at the moment, and hopefully you are going to also be able to buy yourself a Tesla whenever they are going to be implementing the purchase option with Bitcoin, because they are technically thinking about that at the moment. At least that's what I was able to find out. This kind of makes me laugh, because it obviously makes me think back to the people who have bought pizza and some other random things with their Bitcoin, and then prices started going up, and this kind of obviously made their investment not look all that great, to say the least. And this might actually be happening with Tesla as well, with everyone who might want to buy a car with Bitcoin. So maybe get as a, obviously I'm not a financial advisor, so that's your disclaimer right there, but maybe you shouldn't technically buy a Tesla with Bitcoin. I really don't know. You could probably let me know what you think of this whole situation and what you thought of this video. So let me know in the comments down below, and I will hopefully see you in another one. Bye-bye.